1,300 arrested for protesting Putin's mobilization, as others scramble for flights out of Russia. The Kremlin has 4 months fought to maintain a sense of domestic normalcy, while pursuing its faltering war in Ukraine. President Vladimir Putin's declaration of partial mobilization has, for some Russian at least, shattered that illusion. By the time Putin's recorded announcements was done playing on TV on Wednesday, Russians were scrambled to buy the last available flights out of the country, and opposition groups were calling for protests as his order bred a sense of unease at home, just as his nuclear threat sought to do abroad. By late evening, more than 1,300 people had been detained at protests denouncing the move. For the first time, many draft-age Russian men and their families are contending with the prospect of fighting and dying in a conflict the Kremlin just intensified. It's a line Putin has seemed loath to cross despite growing pressure, one that analysts warn could backfire on the Kremlin. "I feel anger for those who made these decisions," said Knisha, 28, a product manager in Moscow, who declined to give her last name out of concern for her safety. "I feel fear for my relatives, friends, acquaintances, and colleagues. I imagine myself in their shoes, forced to go off a war that you didn't choose, that you don't support, that they grab you right off the street to go and fight in." For many ordinary Russians, this late summer morning brought back memories of February 24th, when they awoke to the news that their president had already launched that the Kremlin insist on calling its special military operation. Putin's waited until business hours in Moscow to announce the call up of reservists Wednesday, but the shock was the same. "The news was worse than I expected," said Andrei, 30, a financial analyst in Moscow, who similarly declined to provide his last name out of fear for his safety. "I am stupefied by the decree of adversity and madness to which we now bear witness." Protesters took the street across the country to voice their opposition to move. By Wednesday night, 1,311 people in 38 cities had been detained under Russia's anti-protest law, according to the independent OVD Info Protest Monitoring Group. It said those figures include at least 502 in Moscow and 524 in St. Petersburg, Russia's second most populous city. Throughout Putin's tenure, the Kremlin has fostered a reputation for testing the limits of an arrangement in which Russian citizens largely agree to stay out of politics if the state stay out of their lives, but it has taken demonstration, a sense of restraint, a hesitation to take things too far and risk sparking a broad-scale backlash. Unverified rumors spread of authorities turning men away as they sought to leave the country. The Kremlin declined to comment on whether the border would be closed to those subjected to mobilization order, and it asked people to be patient as the law is clarified. "People are worried. They have a lot of questions," Santonova said. It was said that this was a very limited, short-term special military operation, and there was no need for any participation by ordinary Russians. Now this has changed, but a lot will depend on the scale of this mobilization. It might take months to deliver any tangible change in Russia's fortunes on the battlefield, and if limited mobilization effort fails, Putin's may already have the tools he need to draft any military-age men across the country. "I feel like I am being held hostage by a crazy maniac who every day changed the plan for my death to do something even crazier," said Maxim, 30, an IT manager who also declined to give his last name out of concern for his safety. "My employees are all young and have families. They get these pieces of paper and they don't understand what to do next. They are scared," Maxim said. "This is not their war. They want to live a normal life in a normal country." That's all for today. Thank you and goodbye.